Hi friends. So today we will discuss the teaching aptitude topic from paper 1 of July 2018 paper. In the last video, we have discussed the research aptitude topic from question 1 to 5. So the continuing questions are question 6 to 10, which will be discussed in this video. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel for more beneficial videos. So starting with the questions, question number 6, which of the following set of statements best describes the nature and objectives of teaching? So first let me tell you that this teaching aptitude is really easy topic which could be covered by the students on their own, and this topic does not require any technical skills. Now, which of the following set of statements best describes the nature and objectives of teaching? Part A, teaching and learning are integrally related. So this is true, because teaching and learning are integrally related. A teacher focuses that his or her students studies well, learns well, and have some transformation in their behavior. There is no difference between teaching and training. This is wrong, because there is a difference between teaching and training, as teaching is basically to provide new knowledge to the people, whereas training is providing tools and techniques to the already knowledgeable people. It is basically to add on to the skills and abilities of the already knowledgeable people for a shorter time span. So there is a difference. C, concern of all teaching is to ensure some kind of transformation in the students. So yes, teacher always focuses that his or her students have some transformation in their behavior, so that the teacher knows that there is some transformation, there is some learning going on. D part, all good teaching is a formal in nature. So no, this is not true, because all good teaching is formal in nature. This is not true. Why? Because formal teaching is basically in a classroom scenario, whereas there can be informal teaching as well, which is one-to-one mentoring. E part, a teacher is a senior person. This is not always true, because a teacher does not define a senior person. A teacher could be anyone having knowledge, who could provide knowledge, who could provide teaching to other people. Teaching is a social act, whereas learning is a personal act. This is true, because teaching means teacher is a mediator between the student and the knowledge that he could provide to the students, whereas learning is a personal act. Everyone learns for their own personal benefit. So this is true. So the correct answer, so the correct options are A, F, and C. So the correct answer is option number C. Now question number 7, which of the following learner characteristics is highly related to effectiveness of teaching? So we'll study the options one by one. First is prior experience of the learner. Prior experience of the learner. Now every teacher wants that his or her student have some prior knowledge to the related topic, to the topic which she is teaching. So there is some personal, there is some prior experience of the learner. Now B part, educational status of the parents of the learner. This is irrelevant, because we know that children from the poor background, children from no educational background have so much of knowledge with them. Peer groups of the learner is irrelevant for the effective teaching, and family size from which the learner comes is also irrelevant. So the correct answer here is prior experience of the learner, prior knowledge of the learner which he or she possesses. Now in question number 8, in the two sets given below, set 1 indicates methods of teaching, whereas set 2 indicates the basic requirements for success and effectiveness. So set 1, so we'll read this, lecturing. So what is lecturing? It is basically a teacher is there in a classroom and he is giving lecture to many students at the same time. It is basically a classroom scenario. Discussion in groups basically means that there are 4 to 5 people and there is a theme-based discussion going on in a group. There is one common topic and everyone is discussing about that topic. C, brainstorming. Brainstorming is basically the spontaneous ideas which comes into the mind. So basically, if supposedly a teacher says to the students to think about something, so the student could think it from any point of view, creative thinking is there, and it is irrelevant that whether the idea is relevant to the topic or not, because there is brainstorming going on. Then we have programmed instructional procedure. It is a structured form of teaching wherein the method of it is basically a method of presenting new subject matters to the students in a sequence of control steps, whereas after every step there is a feedback which the teacher gets from the students. So we'll match it with set 2. Lecturing, I have already told you, content delivery in a lucid language. So this is third part. Discussion in groups, we have discussed theme based interaction among the participants, which is 5. Brainstorming, we have already discussed production of large number of ideas. It is irrelevant here that whether the idea is actually appropriate for the topic or not. There could be critical and creative thinking in any direction. So brainstorming, second part. And then programmed instruction procedure, which is basically a small step presentation with feedback provided. So first, so the correct option would include A3, B5, C2 and D1. So option number C is the correct option. Now question number 9. From the list of evaluation procedures given below, identify those which will be called formative evaluation. Now firstly, we'll understand that what is formative evaluation, and the another one, the summative evaluation. So what is formative evaluation? It is basically used to understand the knowledge of the students, that how much the students have understood by the teacher, by the teaching provided by the teacher. So a teacher could ask his students to summarize the lecture in 1 or 2 points, or he could say to provide the feedback to the teacher. Now the teacher may ask him the questions, answers. So basically it is during the process, during the teaching mechanism, during the teaching process, the students are asked about the questions and answers, so as the teacher could understand that what understanding has been gained by the students. Now we have the summative evaluation. Summative evaluation is basically the end process. It is basically the outcome which could be measured by assigning the award grades to the, the teacher assigns the test scores to the students. The teacher assigns the grades to the students. PTMs are held, that is parent-teacher meeting is held in school after every 3 months. So this is example of summative evaluation. Now we'll understand that what is formative evaluation from the options given below. A, a teacher award grades to students after having transacted the coursework. This is summative evaluation. During interaction with students in the classroom, the teacher provides corrective feedback. So this is formative evaluation. The teacher gives marks to students on a unit test. That is a summative evaluation. Teacher clarifies to doubts of students in the class itself. That is formative evaluation. The overall performance of a student is reported to parents at every 3 months interval is summative, whereas the learner's motivation is raised by the teacher through a question answer session is a formative evaluation. So formative evaluation would be B, D and F. So the correct option would be option number D. So basically formative evaluation is to judge, is to understand that how much gaining of knowledge has been there by the students. Now question number 10, which is the last question of this video, that is assertion given is all teaching should aim at ensuring learning. We have already discussed here that teaching mechanism is basically a teacher wants that there should be some transformation in the behavior of her students. There should be some learning going on. So teacher is interrelated with the process of learning, whereas reason given here is all learning results from the teaching, which is not true, because learning does not only is there from the teaching, but it is also through experiments, through observation, through prior experiences of an individual. So all learning results from teaching is incorrect, whereas assertion given here is the correct answer. So the option correct here is A is true but R is false, which is option number C. Do not subscribe to follow this page, to follow this channel for more beneficial videos. Do ask your queries on our Telegram group. Thank you.